everyone, you are welcome to our channel Gem, and please don't forget to subscribe our channel to keep on getting more videos like this. Today I am going to give you a brief introduction about the author Marga Minsoo. Marga Minsoo ranks among the most important Dutch writers. While she started out writing children's stories followed by witty tales about misalliances and misunderstandings, her reputation lies in the novels and short stories dealing with the Holocaust. Indeed, her work has been made required reading for Dutch high school students. The narrator in her work is usually someone who resembles the author, a Jewish eyewitness to the arrest and deportation of her family at the hands of the Nazis.
Thank you. Now, Ms. Kira Sharma will be explaining you the chapter.
Thanks, Nishit. Now, I will explain you the chapter, The Address. It was written by Marga Minsoo. Before I start with the explanation of the chapter, I would like to discuss certain points with you. In today's age, what we find that war has negative impact on the lives of common people. No doubt there is bloodshed, no doubt people lose their families, there is loss of life, there is loss of property. But apart from that, there are times when we come to know about the lives of common people. How the wars affect the lives of common people, this is what presented very beautifully by the author in the chapter, The Address. In this chapter, we come to know about the author and her mother. We come to know how during the war, the difficulties they have faced and what they have done to take care of their possessions and how they wanted to save their possessions and what was the impact of it after the war. So, there are mainly four characters in the chapter. The narrator, Marga Minsoo, Mrs. S., mother of the narrator, Mrs. Darling, an acquaintance of the narrator's mother, a girl of 15, daughter of Mrs. Darling. Now, in this chapter, we will come to know that Mrs. S., who was actually the mother of the narrator, during the war, she had started giving her possessions to her friend, that is Mrs. Darling. What was the time? It was the time of Second World War, from 1939 to 1945. During that time, Hitler and his Nazi soldiers were compelling Jews to go to the concentration camps. As a result, they were treated badly, their things were taken away, and they were living a very bad life. So, because Mrs. S. was facing a great difficulty in that, so she wanted to keep her things at some safe place. That was, she felt that she should give her all possessions to her friend, that is Mrs. Darling. Now, she had kept on giving her things to Mrs. Darling. Now, in the chapter, we'll come to know if actually her friend took care of the things or she changed her mind. Or we can also come to know that maybe that Mrs. Darling was an opportunist who took the misuse of that opportunity and maybe she had taken all her things and then she has not returned. So, let's discuss the chapter. This is the very first passage of the chapter, Do You Still Know Me? Up till, but I knew now that I was right. The difficult words in this passage are cheek, narrow opening, fleetingly for a short time. So, what we come to know in the beginning of the chapter, we come to know Mrs. S. daughter, that is the narrator, she has come to the address of Mrs. Darling. Why she has come there? She has come there because she wanted to take her things which were given to Mrs. Darling during the war by Mrs. S. So she asked that woman if she knew her. The woman looked at her as if she could not recognize who she was. So she kept, she opened the door with a narrow opening. That means she did not open the door properly. And she says that she doesn't know about her. Then the narrator is introducing herself as Mrs. S's daughter. This time she opened the door. She was looking at her as if she has not recognized at her, and she has not recognized her at all. Then she kept on looking at her in silence. So this was the time narrator was thinking that perhaps she has come at wrong address, and because it was being told many years ago, it was many years before when she had come to know about the address. So she thought that maybe she had rung the wrong bell. This time, what she noticed? She noticed that the woman was wearing the cardigan, which was actually her mother's cardigan, and this she also noticed that the buttons of that cardigan have also changed its color. It has become pale from washing. So this time she was trying to hide her cardigan when she noticed that Mrs. S's daughter was observing her cardigan. So she tried to hide herself behind the door, but by this time narrator was sure that it was actually the same address where she had to reach. Second passage starts from, "Well, you knew my mother," up till the woman would have said it was nothing. Now, because she wanted to talk to that lady, she wanted to get all her things which were actually her own possessions. So she wanted to talk to her. This time that lady did not show any kind of pleasant expressions on her face. In fact, she says that I had thought that no one would come back, and I am quite surprised that you are here. She opened the door. This time the narrator says that she had specially come to meet her on the train, but the woman flatly refused to talk to her. She said that it was not convenient for her to talk to her at that moment because she has some other work to do, and she requested her to come to her some other day. So this was the time when she was standing at the step only, and someone from inside was trying to ask about the narrator, but the lady in a very casual way, she said that it is nothing. So this was the time she looked at the nameplate again. It was the same address which was told to her by her mother. It was number 46, and she looked at it. It was written in black letters on white enamel on the nameplate. So seeing this address, now she is thinking about the bygone days, the time during the war. So she is thinking about the time when once she had gone to meet her mother. At that time, it was actually the first half of the war, and she had gone home for a few days. So this was the time when she noticed that there were certain things missed in the room. When she talked about this to her mother, she had told her that it was actually Mrs. Darling whom she had started giving her things. And narrator was quite surprised because she had never heard about Mrs. Darling till now. So she was surprised why her mother had started giving all her things to Mrs. Darling. Then she tells that she had been her old acquaintance, and now she has started meeting her. Now she has been continuously coming to her, and she had developed a very good relationship with the narrator's mother. Next passage starts from, "Every time she leaves till with a full suitcase or bag." The difficult words here are lugging, fittingly, and fit. The meanings are already given. So in this passage, what we come to know, she this time came to know that every time whenever Mrs. Darling came to Mrs. S's house, she always took certain things from Mrs. S's house, and she also told her daughter this time that she had taken the table silver, she had taken all the antique plates, she had also even carried those large vases. And narrator's mother is so much concerned with her. Actually, she thinks that Mrs. Darling is helping her a lot by taking all her things to her house. Actually, she was a very simple kind lady, and she thinks that Mrs. Darling is actually helping her by taking all her things. Even she says that she carries such heavy vases in her hands, and maybe she will face some health issues if she will keep on doing this thing. This time narrator had asked her mother if she had agreed that she should keep all those things with her. So the narrator's mother told her that if she is going to ask her about this thing, it is going to be a kind of insult for her, and she did not want to insult her by asking her this thing. And by this time she was very much sure that her friend is actually going to help her. My mother seems to notice that till that she wore a brown coat and a shapeless hat. So this was the time when she was talking directly about Mrs. Darling with her mother. This time her mother noticed that she was actually not convinced. Narrator was not actually convinced at this moment. So she looked at her in some angry manner, and after that both of them never talked about this thing. So this was all the scenario about her past during that war, and this passage is telling us when she was returning from Mrs. Darling's house this time, when she had gone to ask for the possessions which were given to her by her mother. So this time on the way she was walking in the familiar places again for the first time since the war, but she does not want to give any attention to those things, because all those things were actually giving her some kind of memory which was not the pleasant one, because during the war there was so much bloodshed that she was not happy to see that, and she doesn't want to see those scenarios again. So this time again she remembers the time when she had seen Mrs. Darling for the first time, and again she had seen that Mrs. Darling had taken certain things from her place. She noticed the back of that lady, she had a broad bag, and the woman again picked up that heavy suitcase under the coat rack. She was wearing a brown cap and coat and shapeless hat. Does she live far away till 46? Remember that. You know what is going on at this moment in this chapter? We come to know the present scenario when she had gone to Mrs. Darling's house. Side by side, we discuss in the chapter the moment Mrs. Darling used to come to their place, Mrs. Darling used to take their things from their house, and the way her mother had asked her to remember the address. So this is what she remembers. She asked her mother, when she had seen that lady going out of the house with a heavy case, she asked if she lived at some faraway place. This time her mother told her that she lived in Marconi Street and the number is 46. She asked her to remember that address. I had remembered it till all those years because there were things. Since then, because her mother had asked her to remember that address, she always remembered that address. She had to wait for a long time to go there. In the beginning, after the freedom, she was not at all interested in taking those things. What was the reason? Because the connection, that is her mother, she had already lost her, so she did not want to bring those things which were actually giving her the memory of her mother. Because if she would bring all those things which were actually the belongings of her mother, definitely she will remember her mother and there will be a sudden kind of pain in her heart which she doesn't want to realize. That's why in the beginning she always thought of not going to that place and bringing those things. And what else was there? She thinks that those things would be hidden somewhere in the cupboards and boxes. So she did not feel the need to bring those things. But gradually everything became normal again till I said I'll wait for her. Now the difficult words in this passage are liberation, endured and vain. So slowly and slowly everything became normal, because after war for the time being there was starvation and there were other difficulties faced by the people. But slowly and slowly everything became normal. Bread was getting to be a lighter color, means they were able to get everything to eat. They could get a bed to sleep, means situation was back to normal again. So one day, all of a sudden, she thought of going to that address, that is Mrs. Darling's house, where her mother had kept all her things. Because she wanted to see those things, she wanted to touch those things, she wanted to remember everything related to her mother's memory. So after her first visit in vain, her first visit was total waste. It was completely useless, hopeless one, because Mrs. Darling had flatly asked her to talk to her. So she decided to go there again for the second time. This time a girl of almost 15 years old opened the door to her and she told her that her mother was not at home as she was doing some work. But the narrator says that she would wait for her. I followed the girl along the passage till there should be a burn mark that had never been repaired. So she started following the girl along the passage. What she noticed, there was an old fashioned iron Hanukkah candle holder. She, the narrator is seeing that and she was quite surprised. She says that when it was there at her place, they had never tried to use it because it was quite a difficult task to use that candle holder instead of using the single stick. So they used to use that single candlestick. So the girl asked her to sit there. This time when she was sitting in the living room, she was sitting at a place which she knew and she did not know. What does it mean? Because all the things which were kept in the room, actually they were there, they were their own possession. That means all those things which were kept in the room, all those things were of Mrs. S's belongings. So, but the way they were kept, the way they were kept and the way place they were kept, they, she did not feel as if they, she knew all those things. So, she found herself among those things which actually were kept at her place. But the thing is, all those things were kept in such a tasteless manner that she did not like it at all. Moreover, there was a muggy smell that was hanging there. And this time she also noticed a tablecloth. There still burn mark was there which was still not repaired. My mother will be back soon. Till the word, thank you. So the girl says to her that her mother would be back very soon. And she had already made tea for her. And she also offered tea to the narrator. She thanked her for the scene. I looked up till I had found the burn mark on the tablecloth. So she looked up, the girl was putting the cups, tea ready for tea table. And she had the same broad bag just like her mother, Mrs. Darling. So she put the tea in the white pot. All it had was a gold border on the lid. She opened the box and took out the spoons. She says that this was the time when the narrator was listening to her own inner voice because she was remembering the moments when she had been using those things, when those things were there at her place. So she looks at the, those things and she had turned around, she brought her tea. This time the girl was telling the narrator that her mother tells that all these things are actually antique. She pointed around the room. She says, see for yourself. Then, because the narrator already knew about those things, actually all these were her own belongings only. So she did not feel the need to look around. And then she also remembers the time when they used to eat apple on the pewter plate. She says that they use it for everything. Now the next passage is starting from, yes, I said, till the time I look, it is in here. After that, she discusses about this thing. She thinks that all those lovely things, till the time they are with us in our place, we hardly look at them because we don't give them that much importance as they are kept at our place. But the time comes when we miss those things, maybe because we have sent it for some repair purpose or we have lent it to someone, then automatically we start missing those things. So this is what actually happening at this moment, as she had lost all the possessions of her mother, as all these things are kept at Mrs. Rawlings' place. So she is feeling a sudden kind of pain seeing those things. Now she remembers one particular incident of her life when those silver things were there at her place. She remembers that was a long time ago when she had been to home and because of fever she had to stay home. So that time her mother asked her to polish the silver. So this was the time when she was surprised to know actually the cutlery they were using at their place, that is of silver. So she in a very surprising manner asked her mother that the things which they used to eat in are actually of silver. So this was the time her mother told her that the knives, the forks, the slices, everything in whatever they were using, that is of silver. She had never known about this before. I jumped up till the cutlery fitted in the narrow table drawer. So this was the time when the girl of 15 was continuously telling her about the things, that antique plates and pewter plate, those silver spoons, everything. She was actually showing off the things which were kept there at their place. But she didn't know that she was showing off the things to the girl who was actually the owner of those things. But the narrator saw all those things were kept in such a tasteless manner. They were not arranged in a proper way. So she didn't like it. So immediately she jumped up and she said that she was forgetting the time as she had to catch the train. She had her hand on the door. She says that if she doesn't want to wait for her mother, this time the narrator immediately walked towards the door. She says that she had to go and she would find some other time to meet her. As she was walking down the passage, she heard the jingling of spoons and forks because side by side she was remembering all those things which were actually their own possessions, and it was giving her a sudden kind of pain. One thing, they were not her own possessions now. Other thing, they were used in a very bad manner. And the third thing is that she cannot get it back. There are many reasons. Maybe she talked to her or maybe she would get it back. But then she thought of the place where she was living. She was actually living in a small rented room where there was no place for keeping such antique antique plates or antique things. So she thought of forgetting about the things, because one more thing was there, that these things which were actually linked in her memory, that were actually reminding her of her mother. But if her mother is not there, what she will do with all those things? So she decided to go from the place. I resolved to forget the address till the easiest. So finally she decided to forget the address which was told to her by her mother when she was young, that she should not forget that address, as all her belongings, all their possessions were there at that address. But finally she decided to forget that address, and she also had to forget all the things which were kept there at that place. So that would be the easiest thing to do. So now in this chapter we came to know that how the war has affected the lives of common people. That is the simple life, that is Mrs. S, who had been giving all her things to her friend in a hope that the time comes when the war will be over and she would be able to get all her things back from her friend. But Mrs. Rawlings proved herself to be a selfish kind of lady who just misused the opportunity. She was collecting all the things because she knew that all the Jews were treated in such a bad way that One or the other day, Mrs. S and her family members will also not get a place to live. So as a result, she thought that she should take all the things. She kept on carrying those things, heavy bags she used to carry at her own, because she wanted to rob them as much as she could. So in this chapter, we have seen another kind of face of the war, which we generally don't find in our normal life. So this is what being shown through the chapter, the address. If you are able to understand the chapter, these are very important questions. You must try these questions. There are almost 15 questions in
here.
So these questions you must try. Why was Mrs. Dowling surprised to recognize the author? What had the author to recognize Mrs. Dowling during her first visit? Why did the author feel upset on her first visit to Mrs. Dowling's house? How did the author feel towards the stored stuff at Mrs. Dowling's house? Why did she feel so? Next is, what type of a girl was the author? How did you form this opinion? Next, describe the author's meeting with Mrs. Dowling's daughter. Next, what type of traumas do wars cause? Next, what was the girl thinking when she was traveling home by train? Next, why did she resolve to forget the address? Next, I resolved to forget the address. Of all the things I had to forget, that would be the easiest. Comment. Next, which address had the narrator remembered for years? Why? Next question. Why did the narrator desire to see the stored stuff after so long? Next question. What do you gather about the character of Mrs. Dowling in the story? Next, describe the incident of Mrs. Dowling's daughter opening the box of cutlery. Next question. Why did the author not wait to meet Mrs. Dowling? Now there are some long questions. Do you think the title of the story, The Address, is appropriate? Next question. Comment on the statement, The Address is a story of post-war human predicament. Next question. After reading the story, what opinion do you form about the narrator's character? Next question. It is not easy to let off past memories and possessions. Do you agree? Why not? Next question. Past, whether good or bad, is gone. We must never worry about it. All we need to make the best of our present. Explain with reference to the story, The Address. I hope you have understood the chapter. You must try these questions. And you can give your suggestions in the comment box. Thanks.